Hello friends, when we analyze two databases, we often come across with the situation when we want to compare list 1 with the list 2. For example, here we have a list 1 and list 2 and we want to find out whether this name in this list is same as this name in this list. If there can be a spelling mistake or there can be some other difference, we want to check that whether this and this matches or not. Or we have two lists where the names are not in the same order. So this name might be here in this database, like here we have, but these names are not in front of each other. We want to compare how many of these names are appearing in this list. How to do that? How to compare the two lists? So here in today's video, we are going to learn interesting and amazing ways to compare the two lists. This is going to save you a lot of time and will become efficient in handling the Excel. So stay tuned till the end of this video, and if you are not subscribed to this channel yet, go ahead and subscribe to this channel. So here we have two lists, list 1 and list 2. We just want to compare whether this name in the list 1 and this name in the list 2 matches or not. It is very easy to compare these two names. So we'll just put equal to, we'll use the formula equal to do the true and false. Equal to this cell B5 is equal to this cell C5. So Excel will compare B5 and C5 and will give us the result true or false. It is true because this name and this name matching. So I will just copy this formula down and see how many other names are matching or not. If you see here, there are two false. If the list is big, you can just put the filter Alt-DFF and you can see how many false are there. So these names are not matching with each other. So this is how we can compare the two names, whether they are matching or not from the two lists, when these names are in the same order. If you want to customize this message true or false, you don't want true or false, you want something else like match or not match. So you can go ahead and put the formula if. So I'll use the formula if is equal to if tab. Now what is it asking? Logical test. So I will select this cell is equal to this cell. If this cell and this cell is are same, this is completes my logical test. So I'll put comma value if true. If this cell and this cells are same, what I want matched. So I'll write in double inverted commas matched, double inverted comma, the button which is there near the enter button, you need to press shift and that button, and in between these two double inverted commas write whatever you want. I written here matched for the true comma. What if the these two cells are not matching, value if false. I will write here not matched between two double inverted commas. This completes my if formula and I will enter. Now you will see here whatever is matching, it is saying matched. Whatever is not matching, it is saying not matched. So this is how we can customize true and false. So this is the one method. Now we'll go ahead and learn the second method. Now in this we have two lists. This is the list of different countries. Again, this is another list of different countries, but these names are not appearing in the same order. For example, if you see here United States, it might be there in this list. You can see here United States is over here. So I want to compare list 2 with list 1. That means I want to see how many these names are there which are appearing in the this list, and I want the answer for that. So for that I am going to use the formula VLOOKUP. So is equal to VLOOKUP, I will write the formula tab. Now what is it asking? Lookup value. What is that I want to search in the other list? I want to compare a list 2 with list 1. So I want to search this Mexico in list 1, whether it is there or not, comma table array. Now for table array I am going to select list 1 from here to here. Only this list, this particular column I will select, and then lock this column with the help of F4 button, function key F4, comma, column index number, I have selected one column only, and it is going to search in the this column, first column only. So I will write here 1, comma 0, and complete the formula. Now see what I have written in VLOOKUP formula. VLOOKUP C5, this particular cell, comma, table array, select the list 1. You can select the column as well and lock this particular table array, comma 1 only, because column index number is 1. That is, this is the, because this is the column where it going to search Mexico whether they're present or not, and then 0. Now what is it giving me? Mexico. So Mexico is present over here. I'll copy this formula down. You'll see here, whatever country's name is appearing in the list 2, in front of that, the same country's name is appearing from the list 1. That means Mexico is present somewhere in this list. It is there in this list. Here it is. You can see here. So it is there. So Excel has given us and put the name of the Mexico over here. If you want to find out how many are there, which are there in the list 2 but not there in the list 1, so you can just filter the data and go to NA, and you'll see here these many countries names which are appearing in the list 2 but which are not in the list 1. Similarly, if you want to find out, you want to compare list 1 with list 2, that means which are the countries names which are appearing in the list 1 but which are not appearing in the list 2. So I'll go ahead and put the formula for that as well. Again, the same formula is equal to VLOOKUP. Now lookup value, I'll compare this value from the list 1, United States. This is the cell I will select because I want to compare list 1 with list 2 now, comma, table array. Now I will go ahead and select the list 2, because in the list 2 I want to compare the list 1. So I'm comparing list 1 now with the list 2, and now I will lock this table array, comma, again the column index number is 1, comma 0, and then complete the formula. Copy this down. You'll see here United States is appearing in this list, but China is not appearing in this list. Again, if you see, France is appearing here in this list. These two are matching. So it is giving me in front of France here. If you see, there is a France. So now I will filter again with on NA error. So these many countries' names which are there in the list 1, which are not there in the list 2. Isn't it easy and time saving? Another way to verify whether those names in the list 2 are appearing in the list 1 or not is with the help of COUNTIF formula. Now how do you do that? So I want to check this name in the list 2 whether it is there in the list 1 or not. So for that I will use the COUNTIF formula in this particular cell here. So is equal to COUNTIF. COUNTIF function counts how many times this particular cell, this particular content in the cell appears in that particular range. So what it is asking first, it is asking us the range. Now range, I will give the range of list 1, range of list 1, because I want to check this particular cell, that is Mexico, is appearing in the list 1 or not. So range is list 1. Lock this range with the help of function key F4, comma, and criteria. What I want to check? I want to check Mexico, whether it is appearing in the list 1 or not. And then complete the formula. You'll see here, it is appearing one time in the list 1. That means in the list 2, the Mexico is there, which is appearing in somewhere in the list 1. If you see here, it is appearing in the list 1. I'll copy this formula down till the range of list 2. And you will see there are zeros and ones. So ones are those names in the list 2 which are appearing in the list 1, and zeros are those names in the list 2 which are not appearing in the list 1. So I'll go ahead and filter this zeros from list 2. These are the names which are appearing in the list 2 but not in the list 1. Another way of finding comparing the two lists, list 2 and list 1. If you want to compare list 1 with the list 2 with the help of this formula, just reverse this. Take the range of list 2 and take this one, that is the criteria, as the first cell in the list 1. You will compare list 1 with the list 2. So this is another way of checking the or comparing the list. Okay, now another way to do that, more efficient than this, is use of conditional formatting. The easiest way and efficient way to compare the two lists. So what I will do, I will go here. For now I will delete this column, formula column. I'm going to use conditional formatting on this particular database, list 1 and list 2. So I will select both the list, go to conditional formatting, highlight cell rules, the first one, and you will see here duplicate values. Go to duplicate values. Now what will it do? It will highlight all the duplicates values in this both the list, that means which are appearing multiple times. Now whatever is being highlighted right now, these all the values, that means United States, appearing in the both the list. But I want the values which are not appearing, which are unique values in both the list. So I will go here and select unique values. Now these values, these particular countries names which are appearing only once in both the list. So I will go ahead and say okay. Now you will see here, these are the names of the countries in list 1 which are appearing in the list 1 only but not appearing in the list 2. That means these are not in the list 2. The one which are highlighted in the list 2 are appearing in the list 2 only but not appearing in the list 1. Now this method we should be using only when we are assured that the names are not appearing in the same list double. For example, Austria, Norway, Israel are not appearing in this list again. Then only we can go ahead and use conditional formatting. Otherwise you can use the Villukov formula. That is the best way to do that. If you filter this, filter on text color, filter by color, and you will see here highlighted color, and these are the names which are there in the list 1 but which are not there in the list 2. I will again unfilter the data. Alt-DFS for unfilter, Alt-DFF for filtering the data. Now from the list 2 I will filter by color, that is highlighted one. These are the names which are appearing in the list 2 but not in the list 1. So this is the easiest way to compare both the list. So we have learned the three important ways to compare the two lists. This will save you a lot of time. I hope you like this video. If you are not subscribed to this channel yet, please go ahead and subscribe to the channel. We are going to come out with more such interesting functions and time saving and efficient functions in Excel. So do subscribe to this channel and wait for the next video. Thank you very much.